U.S. job growth expected to have slowed moderately in March, while wage gains will likely remain elevated. Economists are closely watching for the Labor Department's report coming out on Friday. The report is also expected to reflect a jobless rate that's below 4%. This suggests the U.S. economy ended the first quarter on solid ground, potentially delaying anticipated rate cuts from the Federal Reserve. A Reuters survey showed economists expect non-farm payrolls to increase by 200,000 jobs last month, after rising 275 in February. Analysts also say the biggest negative effect of the rate hike on the labor market has already occurred, and the current easing of financial conditions is leading to better job growth in many sectors. U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen in China as she kicks off 4 days of top-level talks with Chinese officials. Yellen held talks with American and foreign business leaders in Beijing. She also met with Guangdong Governor Wang Weizhong. In her opening remarks, Yellen emphasized the need to tackle China's excess production.
The ties between China and the rest of the world, including the United States, are easily apparent here, and this makes it a fitting place for me to visit this week on my second trip to China as Treasury Secretary. Building a healthy economic relationship requires a level playing field for American workers and firms, and open and direct communication on areas where we disagree. And this includes the issue of China's industrial overcapacity, which the United States and other countries are concerned can cause global spillovers.
Yellen also expected to meet Chinese Vice Premier He Lifeng later on Friday. The Philippines, Japan, and the U.S. expected to forge an agreement to hold regular maritime exercises when the leaders of the three nations meet in Washington next week. This is according to Philippine Ambassador to the U.S., Jose Manuel Romualdez, who says the exercises are aimed at deterring any kind of aggression in the South China Sea and preserving the freedom of navigation in disputed territory. The remarks come as the three countries plus Australia are set to hold their first full-scale naval exercise on Sunday amid increasing Chinese aggression in disputed waters. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida, and U.S. President Joe Biden will meet in Washington on April 11. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department, in a briefing earlier told today, Friday, said, aside from the South China Sea issue, the three leaders will also tackle boosting cooperation on various areas, including clean energy and emerging technologies, during next week's meeting.
This trilateral cooperation aims to add value to the existing and prospective areas of work, especially in the economy and economic security, in order to amplify and sustain the momentum of growth in the Philippines and the resilience of the Filipino people. During the summit, the three leaders are expected to discuss their common vision for the Indo-Pacific region, as well as explore opportunities for enhancing trilateral cooperation across various areas of mutual interest. These areas include inclusive economic growth, developing critical and emerging technologies, climate change cooperation and clean energy supply chains, and promoting peace and security in the region.